one sword to rule them all. Hey, Helly34 here, and welcome to my walkthrough for Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess. On the last episode, we got the Blade of Evil Spain Ching, the Master Sword. And on this episode, we're going to do some collection. First of all, you want to head over under this arch here and get our little male snail. Which is odd, because snails don't even have a gender. Like, even if you look on the bug collection screen, it will say it might actually be a girl. Wow, I'd hate to be the snails in this game. Anyways, now we want to go over to where Skull Kid fought us, and there's a few things we can get over there as well. I love this music. Anyways, we have to get our hero's bow, shoot the boulder. Ah! Midna, no. Yeah, talk to Midna, transform into a wolf. Don't be as slow as I was. And here we got our third Poe. Rip out its soul! Postal number 3. As well as getting that, dig under this little area where the boulder was. Transform back into a highland. And this place is filled with Deku serpents. I don't know why. Maybe it's like some sort of... I don't know. Jeez. Just, you know, a few sword slashes as... Wow. Leave me alone. Thank goodness for the shield, right? You can also use the bomb arrows and auto-kill. Yes, another chest will appear, and inside it is... Link, you're supposed to open the chest, not walk around it. Piece of heart number 18. Yay! Alright, now we are two more away from getting here next to heart. Jeez, I can't believe I couldn't count that. Like, what the heck? Anyways, we can... If you remember from last episode, we got the Howling Stone, and... Anyways, our Golden Wolf is in Castletown. Or just below it. You might say that. Now, you could usually run right through here, but no, the postman has to come. How he recognizes Link in wolf form, I have no idea. Greetings, Mr. Link. I've come to deliver a letter. It is a letter from Thelma. Well, my business is concluded. Onward to mail. Yeah, you just go on your... Whoa! I'm sorry. Dropped my nunchuck. What the... Yeah. Okay. Link, there are some folks I want you to meet, so come to my bar right away. These guys will be powerful allies for you. You heard me, come by. I'll be waiting at my Castletown bar. Thelma. Okay. Very helpful. It's optional going there, but we will in a few episodes. Boy, that was a pain. Why did that happen? I guess I just get too excited. So anyways, there's one place I want to show off. I forget the names of the people. I will probably post, some annotations or whatnot, and that stuff. Just talk to this guy. Welcome! Whatever. I'm trying to go in. Excuse me, I'm terribly sorry, but... Well, having a customer in the store with shoes as filthy as yours can make our clients uncomfortable. We hope that you will come back once you have found some more polished footwear. Jeez. Talk to this kid over here. And, hey you, your shoes are grimy. No matter how good your clothes look, you don't look pulled together. If your shoes are dirty, if someone's checking you out, they'll look at your shoes too. I bet they didn't let you in at that snooty shop, did they? Well, what do you think? I'll polish them real nice for 10 rupees. And that's what I'm talking about. I'll polish them so well they'll shine. And indeed they are. Link, your shoes are very shiny. Oh, I wish I had shiny shoes. Can I help you? Would you like me to show you something? I'm one of the richest and most precious customers who value the lives of rupees. So what do you think? 100,000 rupees. Jeez. So that's what I wanted to show you. Just, wow. Even with all the money that we collected in this entire game, I don't think we'll be able to get that many rupees. Boy. So anyways, just head south out of Castletown and so we can go get that golden wolf. If these people would be kind enough to get out of the way, yeah. Anyways, just go off to the left, and our golden wolf will be waiting right there. Also, you can find Agatha out here at her little grass patch, her many little grass patches. Anyways, just, yeah, golden wolf, run over to it, yada yada, wait for it to bite Link's head off. We meet again. This next is the greatest of the hidden skills I have taught you to this point, and it may test the limits of your endurance. You still wish to master it?
Of course.
Very well. But before we begin, I must test you to ensure that you have mastered the last skill I taught you, the backslice. Now then, come at me.
Okie dokes. Really easy.
Excellent. It appears you are certainly capable of performing my lost art. Very well. My fourth hidden skill is the Helm Splitter. Let it be hewn into your mind. It is impossible to circle around and perform a backslice against fully armored enemies that move swiftly in combat. Against such foes, you must first use a shield attack to make them flinch, but then quickly press A. You will leap into the air of the enemy's head and greet them with your blade by immediately striking from behind. This is the Helm Splitter. Show it to me.
Okay, so yeah. Pretty simple. Shield attack, A, and another attack.
Impressive. Do not miss your chance to land a Helm Splitter with A after your shield attack. The fourth hidden skill, the Helm Splitter, has been passed on.
You know, I did that fancy sword thing once, but it was off screen when I was trying to catch up.
There are still three hidden skills for you to learn.
Do not neglect your daily sword training between now and the time you come to learn the next skill. And we meet again. If I recall, I didn't even use the backslice between last time and this time. So anyways, just come over and warp over to Lake Hylia. Or Lake Me, as I like to call it. Now, there are a few things we can get here. Where am I going? Aha! If I'm going the right... Yes, I'm going the right way. Am I? Yes. Yeah, first of all, you want to head over to Linera's Spring. And transform into a Highland. Get your claw shout out. Did I say claw shout? I think I did. Well, anyways, just hookshot your way. I say claw shot, and then I go around and say hookshot. I really... Oh, boy. As well as your... Where is that thing? Lantern. Anyways, come on through this door. And there are a few chests over here, but our main goal is to light the torches. Link, stand closer to it. As awesome as you are, you still can't light these things from like three... Link, open the chest! Piece of heart number 19. Now, in here is a yellow ruby, I believe. Blue ruby. The other one's yellow ruby, I think. Bombs. Oh my gosh. Jeez, what the heck? I swear, last time I opened these chests, that was a yellow ruby. Oi. This game just doesn't want me to... Nah. This time. I actually don't know what I was aiming at. Something for a different item later, maybe? Okay, so anyways, now we can leave the spring. Transform into a wolf, because I think that's way faster than just running around and having to form. It's like, you get to dash, whereas regular Link gets to roll, and it doesn't do anything for your speed. At all. Now there's a little ladder here that we can climb up. Once again, get out your bomb arrows. I'm blind! We will go in there next episode. Just wanted to clear the way out. And now we have a new Howling Stone. If I don't completely screw it up like the last one. Okay, see, when I'm not talking, I can get it. This is the Goron Lullaby from Majora's Mask.
Let teachings of old pass to you. Take sword in hand and find me.
Now, he's going to appear off the map in our next area, which we won't get to until I get back to the main story. See, off the map. I won't tell you where it is because, yeah, I'm not spoiling it. So anyways, thank you for watching this episode for Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess. On the next episode, we will take on the Lake Hylia Cavern. See you all then!